Cowell's Americanized neo-Baroque idiom is perhaps also an answer to Stravinsky's neoclassical works of the same period, with their conscious stylistic references to Bach. But while Stravinsky's works employ elements of Bach's own sound, Cowell is closer in style to the modal folk hymns of his childhood memories. Cowell's Tenth Symphony, which we're going to hear in this concert, completed in 1953, is actually a composite work. It is in six movements. The opening two movements first saw the light of day in 1946 as Hymn and Fuguing Tune No. 5 for String Orchestra. Cowell simply rescored this opus for orchestra. Similarly, the fifth and sixth movements are reorchestrations of music for a string quartet of 1947. Hymn, Chorale, and Fuguing Tune No. 8. The hymn became the intermezzo, while the chorale and fuguing tune became the symphony's finale and title, simply Fuguing Tune. The middle two movements were composed specifically for the new symphony. While Cowell's Tenth Symphony had been written for a tour of Israel to have been made by the Chamber Orchestra of the Vienna Symphony in 1954, neither this tour nor the intended premiere of the new work ever took place. The Symphony No. 10 was premiered in 1957 by the New York Symphony under the baton of Franz Bibo. It is being performed for the first time ever by the Chicago Symphony in this concert. The first movement is marked Allegro, the second Allegro, the hymn and fuguing tune. The third movement, Andante con moto, the fourth Allegro, then the final hymn and fuguing tune, Allegretto quasi andante, then the last movement, Maestoso, and then Allegro. Christopher Keene, the Chicago Symphony, and Henry Cowell's Tenth Symphony.